Now at 6, hundreds of people are back in their homes after they were evacuated in the middle of the night because of a massive factory fire. Good evening, I'm Alyssa Ivinson. The fire started last night around 11:30 at the CNR plating factory in Columbia City. News Channel 15's Holly Campbell went there today and caught up with people returning to their homes.
This was the second fire at CNR plating in the past few years. The first was a chemical fire, and crews feared last night's could have been one, too.
Woke up with a bunch of lights flashing.
The doorbell was ringing, and a fireman showed up.
There was just people everywhere walking across the sidewalk, and I don't know, it was just one of those things you wouldn't expect to happen in a small town.
A fire at the CNR plating facility in Columbia City sparked a wake-up call around midnight for hundreds of people living nearby.
We have about 200 homes that were evacuated, maybe a little bit more than that. So population-wise, we're probably looking around 400 to 500 people.
Mayor Ryan Daniels says the fire started in a dryer box just before 11:30 Friday night. Because the facility uses several chemicals to make different metals, firefighters evacuated the 20 blocks of homes. Some chose to stay.
It was just easier to close up the house and go back to bed.
Others took their families to a shelter at a nearby church.
We didn't know exactly what was going on, and it had a pretty rancid smell, and it, like I say, smelled like burning rubber, and I thought, well, who knows what that is, so we went ahead and left.
The majority of these smells and smoke was really building material. There was some concern because of the chemicals that CNR plating does use, but none of that was actually on fire.
After officials determined it was not a chemical fire, people were given the all clear to go home around 4:30 Saturday morning. Thankful, responding crews made sure to keep them safe.
Those guys were on it immediately, so that was really nice.
The cause of the fire is still under investigation. There were no reported injuries. Holly Campbell, News Channel 15.